the file processing system and the drawbacks of file processing system, how DBMS overcomes the disadvantages of file processing system. Before database management system softwares, they were actually coming into the picture in 1992. Before 1992, there were no DBMS softwares. So people used to store the data in files. Can anybody tell me what do you mean by file? Yes, you can write your answer in the chat box. What is file? Yes, yes, it is type of file, Shreya. It is type of file. My question is, what is file? Okay, source of storing information, Can I consider Notepad is a file? Notepad is a text editor in which you type something and you store the file with the name .txt. Anything which has the extension .c, .cpp, .java, right? .txt, .doc, .xls, these are all files. We use basically files for storing the information, to store the data. So are there any disadvantages of using files to store the data, which is really important for an organization? Yes, there are many disadvantages, because file processing system allows us to store the data, but it does not have other features of DBMS softwares. Like, there is no mechanism for data redundancy and inconsistency. The first major drawback of file processing system is there is data redundancy and inconsistency. What is data redundancy? Redundancy means duplication of the same data again and again in the same file. Consider that roll number 2 having the name Rahul. His data is repeated, suppose 10 times into the same file with different roll numbers. One time his roll number is 2, another time his roll number is 5, next time his roll number is 10, and so on. So because of this duplication, it is difficult for the end user to fetch the data of Rahul. He will always get different entries with the same name Rahul, because his roll numbers are different at different places, right? In the same file. Because of this duplication, we are not able to get exact details of the student from the student database. And that ability of not getting the data, exact data from the database, is called inconsistency. You are not able to get your exact information from the database. That is called inconsistency. There are multiple file formats people may use to store the data. Consider an example of college database management system. Suppose there is no DBMS software in the backend. And consider that these people are using and storing your data into the Excel. Some people are storing your data into doc file. Maybe some are using into text file. So it is very difficult for end user to get the information from different file formats and keep it into one file format. Duplication of information always lead to the inconsistency. Okay. Another disadvantage of file processing system is that difficulty in accessing the exact data from the database. If you are using file processing system, there is always difficulty in accessing the data from the database. Consider that you have written a Java program or a C program to store the information of students' marks in the database. Suppose you use that file processing system. .c, .java is also file, correct? And you are storing the data with the help of, say, arrays, structure, and into the database, correct? So it is difficult for, suppose I am a teacher and I want to know how many students have scored more than 70% marks through that Java program. It is very difficult for me to get it easily, because I need to write a different code, set of code, different function to get that information from the Java program or C program. because that particular requirement have not been coded into the program. Every new requirement from the user need to be write a different code for it. Correct. So here, if you see in the second line, difficulty in accessing data, they have written that here you need to write a new code or a program to carry out each new task. Say if someone wants from the same program, someone wants the list of students in between 30 and 40, roll number 30 and 40. So again, that code is not written in the program. So it is difficult to get it from it. Then what to do? We need to write a code for getting the data whose roll number belongs to 30 and 40, in between 30 and 40. So it means that every new requirement in FPS need to write a different code for it. That is extra burden for an end user, right? So this is called as difficulty in accessing data. Next drawback is data isolation. Your data is isolated. It is scattered in different files always. Consider an example of college management system. Your data, accounts information will be, fees information will be stored into the account file. Your academics details will be there in the department file, suppose. Your marks details are there in the exam section, in the exam section file, right? So different means your student data is now stored in different files. And they are using different format, because file may be a text file, a document, or Excel file also. And it is very difficult for any user to get the different data from different files. If your data is stored in three different files, I need to fetch three different files and collect your data. So that is a time-consuming process. Next drawback is integrity problems in file processing system. What do you mean by data integrity? Data integrity refers to the correctness of the data. It refers to the correctness of the data. Say you are designing a software for voting management, voting system, suppose. So the people who have the age more than or equal to 18 are allowed to give the vote. Otherwise, their vote should be rejected. So what is data integrity concerned here in this particular software is, we are going to check the age of the person always. Whoever comes to the system, we're going to check age of the student or age of the person. If his age is greater than or equal to 18, he must be allowed to give the vote. Otherwise, his vote must be rejected. If you take the example of banking system, your account balance should not be zero. It should be always positive. It should be than zero. So you can put an integrity constraint like this. You see this example. Your account balance should be greater than zero. So whoever balance is negative, they should be intimated that it's your account balance is going down. Please deposit the money in the bank, right? Or if someone wants to withdraw money from your account, money from the bank, and if your balance is zero, the error message should be prompted that there is no sufficient money in the bank account. You cannot withdraw money from the bank. So these are certain conditions. Conditions are constraints in databases. So we cannot write such constraints in my notepad or any file processing system, right? So it is difficult. Integrity problems are there in file processing system. The next drawback is atomicity of updates. Suppose you are typing a document, consider you are storing your data into a notepad file or Microsoft Word document. You are typed, suppose, 20 pages of text into the Microsoft Word document. And suppose you have not saved your data, you have not saved the file, and power goes off. What will happen, students? Please write your answer in the chat box. You are typing a large document, say 20 pages have been already over. If the document is not saved, right, what will happen? If the power goes off, what will happen? Whether the data remains into the Microsoft Word document? No. So Ashwin Nachiketa Pati is saying that data will be lost. Correct. Everything gets lost in file processing system. Right. So that is a major drawback of atomicity of updates in file driven system. So when this type of problems occurs, a failure may occur due to power, due to hardware failure, due to software errors. There are many different types of errors which will occur into the system. Failure may leave database in inconsistency with partial updates carried out. Now, take an example of DBMS software. Suppose you are going to the ATM center to withdraw some money, and the ATM center is using DBMS software like Oracle, Microsoft SQL Server, and so on. You want to withdraw. Suppose your balance is 10,000, you want to withdraw 2,000 from it. You insert the card, you put the amount, you put the password for withdrawal, and if the transaction is successful, the money will be come out of the ATM machine, right? And you get the receipt that this is the money that you have withdrawn and the balance is this much. This is the actual process of database, how database gets updated into the banking system. Now take an example. You insert the card. There is 10,000 in your balance. You check the balance that there is 10,000 now. Then you type 2,000 for withdrawal. You want to withdraw 2,000. You enter the amount. Correct. And now you get the receipt before the money comes out. You get the receipt that the transaction is successful. On the screen also, you're getting the message that transaction is successful and power goes off. Suppose power goes off or any error occur. Suppose the machine does not have sufficient amount or the notes are not available inside the ATM. Though you are getting the message that the transaction is successful, the money will not come out of the machine. You are not received the amount, 2,000 rupees. Then what will happen? Can anyone tell me what will happen? Please write your answer in the chat box. The another case I have given to you. What will happen? You wanted to withdraw 2,000 rupees from the bank. You got the receipt that the transaction is successful. Notes are not available or power goes off in between. Before the money comes out of the ATM, power goes off. Then what will happen? Whether your 2,000 gets lost or the transaction gets cancelled or the transaction gets rolled back, what will happen? Is it happened to you students anytime? Okay. Got the answers from Tushar, Nachiketa, and Ranak Thakur. Good. All of you are right? Correct. Tuduja is also right. Very good. Rishikesh. Excellent. Your answers are correct, student. Nowadays, what happens? Every DBMS software has different set of managers into or different modules into it. So there is called as transaction, which handle this type of logs. So whatever the transaction gets cancelled or due to power failure or due to any error, those transactions are recorded into one some another file, and that is called as transaction log file. And this manager, at the end of the day, you can say, or maybe after 2 hours, 3 hours, once the banking hours gets over, the manager, transaction manager, checks what are different transactions, such transactions happened in a day. It try to roll back those transactions. So what will happen? Your 2,000 which was withdrawn and shown on the receipt that the 2,000 had been withdrawn from your account, what will happen? This 2,000 gets added into your bank account. So again, your balance remains as it is, the balance that was there before you started the transaction. So your money is not gets lost. This is a better example of DBMS versus FPS. You can say there is no data loss in case of database management system softwares. But if this type of banks, you are using Excel or you can say Word document or any other files to handle this, then definitely you would have lost your 2,000 rupees. That's why many big organizations, many big companies, they use database management system softwares for their daily transactions. Millions of transactions are happening in a bank on a daily basis. So there we cannot use file provisioning system. Okay, another disadvantage student for file provisioning system is concurrent access by multiple users. Nowadays the operating systems are advanced. Consider an example where there was no DBMS software, Windows NT or any operating system before that. If a file is opened on one machine and everybody is having the access to that file, if one user open that file on one machine, the rest of the users will not get access to that file. Whenever they want to open that file, they'll get the message on the screen that the file is already open. It happens in before 1990s, right? Because those operating systems were not advanced. They were not smart or real-time OS that time. There were no real-time OS. So if one student access the file, opens the file, other students will get the message that the file is already open. You cannot have access to that file now. So when the other student will get the access to that file, whenever the who opened that file closes the file, other students will get the priority to open that file, correct? So it works in a sequential fashion. Concurrent access needed for better performance of the system, which is actually not given by file processing system. Concurrent access by multiple users is not possible in file processing system. Nowadays, if you see, the operating systems are advanced. You can say that this is possible, sir. If I open one file on one machine, the same file can be also accessed on the another machine also. That is possible nowadays because the operating systems and file processing systems are advanced. I am considering the example of 1990s, where there were no advanced operating system, no real-time systems available. In those situations, they were able to use a file at once only, by one user at a time, correct? Uncontrolled concurrent accesses can lead to the inconsistencies. Okay, so to understand this second point, uncontrolled accesses can lead to the inconsistencies. Consider an example of, say, again, a bank, and you have husband and wife have the joint account in a bank. Consider the example of a joint account of husband and wife in a bank. Say there in their account they have only 10,000 rupees. They stay in the same city. They entered into the different ATM centers in the same city, suppose. They want to read their balances. So they insert the card, they read the balances. Both of them will get 10,000 on this screen. Correct? Now, before husband withdraws any amount from that account, wife withdraws 2,000 from it. Correct? Wife withdraws 2,000 from that account. What will happen? Now, husband wants to withdraw 1,000 rupees from the account. So when both transaction gets complete, both of them will get the receipt from the ATM center. Wife will get that there is 8,000 rupees remain in the bank account, in her bank account. Whereas what happens with the husband? He will get another receipt in another ATM center that when he checked, the balance was 10,000. When he withdraws 1,000 rupees from the bank, and when actual receipt came from the ATM center, the receipt says that only 7,000 rupees there in the bank. So these are called as blind rights operation. This type of problems occurs because of the concurrent access by multiple users. If multiple users are working on the same database or same account, then these type of things will going to happen. Husband thinks that I have only withdrawn only 1,000 rupees and now I am getting a receipt of only 7,000 rupees there in the bank. There is a conflict. So this type of problems may occur, and this will be actually handled by DBMS softwares very nicely. DBMS softwares allows concurrent access by multiple users. Then when he get the detailed statements from the ATM center, he can check at what time which money gets withdrawn, right? So 2,000 was withdrawn 1 minute before he withdraws, suppose 10,000 rupees, then he will get everything on the screen. And then he can understand that somebody, family member or wife has withdrawn that money from the bank. So that is possible in DBMS software. It is not possible in file browsing system. The last disadvantage this book has mentioned is security problems. There are security problems in file browsing system. Can anybody tell me, students, before I explain this point to you, can anybody tell me what type of security you can give to a file? Any file? What type of security you can provide to the file? Please write your answer in the chat box. You saved your time to the file and you want to secure it. What you are going to do so that nobody else can modify it, nobody else can access it? Yes, Shreya has written. Okay. Restrictions on write operation. Good. Read only. You mean to say Shreya, read only? Nachiketa is saying add a password. Very good. Password encrypt karke kar sakte. Good. Rishikesh. Okay. Have you ever tried this, students? Giving a password to the file? Have you ever done this? You created the file and then you saved it with the help of password? Very good. Many of you are saying very good. Yes, yes. Now, are you using a laptop or a desktop or mobile? If you are using, the students who are using laptop or desktop, just type in Google how to break the file password. Not giving access to the other users. Okay. Now, the students who are using laptop or desktop, you can open in another tab. In the another tab, you write in Google, type how to break the password of a file. You will get different websites which allows you to input the file, break the password, and the file will be opened in front of you. Your entire data will be visible to the end users. So is it secure? File browsing systems. Anybody is trying on your machine? Yes, those who are using laptop or desktop, just open another tab. In that you type how to break the password of a file. You will get a platform which allows you to input the file whose password should be broken, and then that particular website or the software will break the password of that you have given to the file, and you can open that file. Okay, so you can try this later on. You can try this later on. This is possible. Anybody can break the password of a file, and the entire file data will be visible to that particular user. So that you can say that these file browsing systems are not secure. They are not at all secure. That's why we have DBMS softwares. DBMS softwares has high end of security. They provide high end security to all the accounts, all the transactions that are happening in the bank. Everything should be secure. That's why all the big companies, all MNCs, all big banks, they use reputed softwares like Oracle, Microsoft SQL Server, DB2, and so on. Okay, so remember this point, that there is no data security in terms of file processing system. It is hard to provide access to some but not all data of the file. Now, another question to you, students. In case of file processing system, you have an Excel file, suppose. Your data is there, important data is there, and you want to share that data with your friend. You want to share only part of the data but not all the data. Is it possible in file browsing system? Please write your answer in the chat box. Yes, students, is it possible? You have one file and you want to give a partial access to your friend. That is not possible. That is not at all possible in file browsing system. Now, just we will revise what are the points that we have discussed in file browsing system, drawbacks of file browsing system, and then the another question that may be asked in your examination. Compare file browsing system versus DBMS. And another question may be asked on the same point. What are the advantages of DBMS over file browsing system? This question may be asked for 5 to 10 marks in your exam, final exam. So this is very, very important topic.